Now, how many of you folks like that old swing dance stuff? That old swing music? Well, I do too, and you're in for a real treat tonight. We have the 5-Point Swing Band. They were with us last year, I know, and they are back truly by popular demand because they really do it the way it's supposed to be done, led by saxophonist Matt Jablonka. Did I say it right, Matt? Okay, good. Matt does a great job with these folks. As you can see, it's a big band, and they're going to entertain you tonight. Now listen, we have a dance floor, and I don't think they mind if y'all come down and do a little dancing, okay? That'd be all right? So just come on around. We come down the stairs. We've got chairs down here, and enjoy this dance floor. So without further ado, let's have a big Williamson County Fair welcome for the 5-Point Swing Band.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Williamson County Fair. This is 5-Point Swing, the Williamson County Swing Band. We've been playing in a number of places and venues this summer, and we'll be doing a little bit more. Looking forward to the Heritage Ball coming in September. That first tune was a tune written by Nashville native Don Gibson, but it was a more upbeat version, and was written for Count Basie and Ray Charles way back in the 60s. We're going to slow down a little bit for the next tune, a tune that you, I'm sure, recall. tune called Don't Blame Me. Chuck Hamilton on flugelhorn. Let's bring out Kimberly Johnson for our first vocal of the evening. Here's Kimberly singing Orange Colored Sky.
Minding my business, when out of an orange colored sky, flash, bam, out of
ladies and gentlemen, here's a real treat that doesn't happen very often in big swing bands. We're going to feature our trombone section that we call the Fabulous Four. And they are going to do an arrangement of a slow tune that Doris Day did back in the 50s, I think, called Secret Love. And here's an upbeat version featuring our trombone section. Now I'd like to introduce to you our other vocalist. His name is Michael Brown. He hasn't been with us quite as long as Kimberly has, but he is doing some fabulous work. Here's an old tune by Frank Sinatra, The Lady is a Tramp.
She gets too hungry for dinner at 8. She loves the
the theater, but never ever comes late. She never bothers with people she hates. And that's why that lady is a tramp. She doesn't like crap games with barons and earls, and won't go to Harlem dressed in ermine and pearls. She won't dance dinner with the rest of the girls. And that's why that lady is a tramp. She likes to be fresh wind in her hair. Life without care. She's broke, but it's open. She hates California, cause it's cold and it's dead. And that's why that lady is a tramp. I'm gonna swing, ladies and gentlemen.
Dave McCullough on trumpet.
course, was Glenn Miller's Little Brown Jug.
Well, on behalf of Five Point Swing, we are so glad to be here for our second year. We want to thank Diane Giddens, who is, if you don't know her, she's the queen of the fair, people. You just need to know who she is. She literally, I think, makes all this happen. But we love being here. I love being part of this because we are Middle Tennessee, even though we're technically, say, we're Williamson County's band. We are from Rutherford County and Murray County and Williamson County. And we got any Davidson County? Nope, that's it. Franklin County. They're so entertaining. Anyway, we have added a really great song to our list because we are in Music City area and you can't be in the Nashville area and not do a little crazy. This is how we do.
Here's Tom.
next we'd like to do a tune made famous probably in the 1930s by Count Basie and his orchestra. He had a couple of fellows who played with him and did some arranging. Their names were Billy and Buster Moten. Here's a tune called Moten Swing. We're getting a little competition from the back someplace. Anyway, here's a tune from the Great American Book of Standards, a tune I'm sure you'll remember, for sentimental reasons. Thank you. Randy Frame on trumpet. Bring Michael back now for another Frank Sinatra song called For Once in My Life.
Touch what my heart used to dream of long before I knew someone warm like you could make my dreams come true. For once in my life, I won't let sorrow hurt me, not like it's hurt me before. For once I've got something I know won't desert me. I'm not alone anymore. For once I can say, this is mine, you can't take it. Long as I know I have love, I can make it. For once in my life, I've got someone who needs me.
The next tune is a little bit, I guess, Latin, maybe Beguine in nature, called The Girl from Ipanema. Who said that?
I dare you.
Do you?
Why not?
So maybe a little neck and cold that one?
Why not?
One kiss, then we can
so I have to park outside of her door till it's light.
I say if he tries to kiss me, I'll cry.
I dry her tears all through the night, hand in hand to a barbecue stand. Right from her doorway we roam.
Each and every it's a pleasure again, walking my baby. Tune that we just added to the book this season. I think you'll enjoy Sam's Boogie.
Thank you.
Here's a tune that'll get your feet a-tapping. We've been playing this for a couple of seasons now. It's called Give Me the Simple Life. We're going to play one more tune before we take a very short break for about 5 minutes so the band can get a glass of water. This is a tune I'm sure you've heard before called the 2 o'clock Jump.
Thank you.
We're going to start the next set with a little Glenn Miller. This tune was recorded by Glenn
Oh, yeah. Start to play, dance with me, make me sweat. Thank you.
Thank you, folks. Have a great evening. Enjoy the fireworks. We hope to see you again next year.
Welcome to Poets from the Neighborhood. My name is Michael J. Tucker.
And I'm Catherine Moore. We hope you'll enjoy the poems we're reading today, poems written by your friends and neighbors. August Love in Tennessee by Lydia Esmer. August Moon, Cricket Song, Summer Soon, says so long. Save a space. Lake's the place. Make a dash. Last cool splash. Skip the fair. Don't you dare. Walking mares. Goats quite rare. Hot dogs, please. Potluck beans. Sweet iced teas. Granny's greens. Barbecue. Trimmings too. 92 form a queue. Mauve sunrise. Dahlias bright. Corn blue skies, starlit night. Something strange, winds of change. Butterfly heaves a sigh. Front porch swing, peach ice cream. Free to dream as we sing. You to me, I to you. Honeybee, honeydew.
Struggle by Margaret Susie Ross. Often I hear music from nowhere, from somewhere, from you, opening my heart again before I have time to close the door.
Sea Lover by Mary Lane. But the sea can't call as a lover to me, for it hasn't the needs which seemingly I must know. To follow the moon and move with the wind, arch into shore, slide out again, to bring me a gift on its gentle waves, or roll out my life in loud, crashing sprays, is just the same in this mindless thing to which I am linked by the salt in my vein, kept in my jeans when I crawled onto land. But that's enough of reality. If the sea were a lover and called to me, I would go.
In Awe by Vera Gerard. Are cardinal red and cawing blue jay, golden finch to green parrot, brush strokes of joy from Almighty's palette? Are fluttering butterflies, spotted and striped, flowing designs from God's kaleidoscope?
From a series of poems I wrote that are variations on William Carlos Williams' The Red Wheelbarrow. Variation, what is need, a la Edna St. Vincent Millay. The orchards are barren now, and black clouds upon them, all that stood so white in the spring. I would give anything to recall sweet red circles and the rainy dust on lost plums. Anything. I raise my arms into the gray, ambiguous glaze they depend upon and wait.
Catching Rays by David B. Stewart. He flipped the pages of his book and never knew what time it took. Rainy days or sun and shine, you'd find him there till dinner time. Nearly hidden in the stacks, nibbling from his sandwich sack, he drank up words in gray and black and kept them, never put them back. Those words are stuck inside his head. I'm sure they'll be there until once he's dead. So tightly jammed between his ears, to get them out would take him years. I find him near a bench these days, just him and Cato catching rays. Cato's what he calls his cat. Sometimes he can't remember that. I wonder what those words still say. They can't get out. They're locked away. He turns the paper in his lap and asks me, "Have you met my cat?" Thank you for watching Poets from the Neighborhood. We hope you'll join us again soon.